know. But in our little village of Anatevka, you might say every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a simple, pleasant tune without breaking his neck. How do we do this, you ask? That I can tell you in a word. For everything. How to eat, how to sleep, how to wear clothes. Because of our traditions, everyone knows who they are and what God expects them to do.
Shaky ass. As a Fiddler. finish milking?
Yes, Mom.
You were reading again. Why does a girl have to read? Will it get her a better husband? Here.
Mama! Mama, Yint is coming!
Maybe Yint has finally found a good husband for you, Zidal.
From your mouth to God's ears.
Mama, Dad, can we go outside and play?
Go.
But Mama, the men Yint finds, the last one was so old, and he had no hair.
You want hair? Marry a monkey.
I'm saying.
horse loses shoe just before the Sabbath. It's enough you pick on me. Bless me with 5 daughters. A life of poverty. But what have you got against my horse? I know it's no shame to be poor, but it's no great honor either. You made many, many poor people. But would it have been so bad if I had just a small fortune?
If I were a rich man, yeah, dum. All day long I'd bitty, bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Yeah, dum. If I were a bitty, bitty rich, yidle, needle, dido, dido man, I'd have a big tall house with the rooms by the dozen right in the middle of the town. Fine tin roof with the real wooden floors below. And there'd be one long staircase just going up, and one even longer coming down, and one that's leading nowhere just for show. Oh, if I were a rich man, dum. All day long I'd bitty, bitty bum. If I were a wealthy man, I wouldn't have to work hard. Dum. All day long I'd bitty, bitty bum. Idle man. If I were rich, I'd have the time that I lack to sit in a synagogue and pray, and maybe have a seat by the eastern wall, and I'd discuss the holy books with the learned men 7 hours every day. That would be the sweetest thing of all.
Well, that would be nice. If they would agree, then I would agree. But until that golden day comes, Reverend, how will you live?
By giving lessons. Do you have children?
5 daughters.
5 daughters. Well, girls should learn too. Girls are people.
A radical.
I'd be willing to teach them. Open their minds to great thoughts.
I am a poor man. Food for lessons. Good. Then stay the Sabbath with us.
Good Sabbath, Reptevia.
Protect and defend.
What's the occasion? A party?
Maybe a party, maybe even a wedding.
Try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match.
You agree?
I agree.
Tevye, that's wonderful.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
And most importantly, to life, to life, L'chaim.
L'chaim, L'chaim, to life. Here's to the father I tried to be.
Here's to my bride to be.
Drink L'chaim to life.
God would like us to be joyful, even when our hearts lie bending on the floor. How much more can we be joyful when there's really something to be joyful for?
To life, L'chaim.
Zaito, my daughter,
my wife.
It gives you something to think about, something
to drink about.
Drink
L'chaim to life.
Understand?
Papa is enough.
No, Mama.
That was a very interesting lesson, Kerchik.
Thank you.
But I don't think the rabbi would agree with your strange ideas.
Certainly. Any new idea would be strange to you. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes, but he was not speaking to you personally. Good day.
You have spirit. Maybe even a little intelligence, perhaps.
Thank you.
And you are very brave. Do you know that in the city, boys and girls can hold hands together? They can even dance together. New dances. Like this.
Gave each other a pledge. Unheard of. Absurd. They gave each other a pledge. Unthinkable. Where do they think they are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America? Doesn't anyone ask the father anymore?
I've wanted to ask you for some time now, Reptevia.
But you're just a poor tailor.
Even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. And I promise you, your daughter will not starve.
He's beginning to talk like a man. On the other hand, what kind of a match would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, things could never get worse for them. They could only get better. And look at my daughter's face. She loves him. She wants him. And look at my daughter's eyes. So hopeful. Tradition! Oh. All right, children. When shall we make the wedding?
Thank you, Papa.
Reptevia, you won't be sorry.
I won't be sorry. I'm sorry already.
Oh, Golda! What am I gonna tell Golda?
Book.
No, it's mine.
Thank you, Abba.
Good day, Abba.
Good day,
Fiddler.
take him inside.
Please don't be upset, Huddle.
Why should I be upset? If you must leave, you must.
They expect me in Kiev tomorrow morning.
So you told me. Then goodbye, Virgin.
Huddle, your father and these others here think that what happened at Seidel's wedding was a little cloudburst, and it's over, and everything will be peaceful again. But it won't, you understand?
Yes, I suppose I do. Goodbye, Virgin.
Before I go, there's a certain question I would like to discuss with you. A political question.
Yes?
The question of marriage.
This is a political question?
Yes, and I personally am in favor of it.
Are you asking me to marry you?
Yes, in a theoretical sense, I am.
I was hoping you were.
And we can consider ourselves engaged, even though I'm going away. As soon as I can, I will send for you. It'll be a hard life, Huddle.
But it'll be less hard if we live it together.
Good evening.
Good evening, Reb Tevye. I have some bad news. I must leave this place.
Well, I'm sorry, Pritchard. We will all miss you.
But you can also congratulate me.
Oh, congratulations. For what?
We're engaged.
Engaged?
Yes, Papa. We're engaged.
No, you're not. No. I know you like him, and he likes you, but you're going away, and you are staying here. So have a nice trip, Perchik.
Please, Papa. You don't understand.
I understand. I gave my permission. Model and title. So you think you also have a right, but my answer is still no.
Papa, you don't.
We'll find someone else for you, here, in Anatevka.
Reb Tevye, we're not asking for your permission.
You're not asking for my permission?
But we would like your blessing, Papa.
I can't believe my ears. My blessing? For what? For going over my head? Impossible. At least with Model and Zidel, they asked me. They begged me. But now, whether I like it or not, she'll marry them.
Reb Tevye, as soon as I can, I will send for her and marry her.
They're going over my head. Unheard of. Absurd. For this they want to be blessed? Unthinkable. I'll lock her up in her room. I couldn't. I should. You look at my daughter's eyes. She loves him. tradition. Ah! Okay, children. You have my blessing. And my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa! You don't know how happy this makes me.
What else could I do?
Thank you, Papa!
Thank you, Papa! Golda! Golda?
Ah, Golda.
I have just been talking to Perchik and Hoddle. They seem very fond of each other.
And?
And I have given them my permission to come to you.
What? Without even asking me?
Well, who asks you? I'm your father.
Who is he? He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
Otto loves him. It's a new world. Golda, do you love me?
Do I what?
Do you love me?
I
she dresses warm. Dear God, how long can that miserable horse of mine complain about his leg? If I can walk on two legs, then why can't he on three? I know, I shouldn't be too hard on him. He has the right to be hungry. He has the right to be sick. He has the right to work like a horse. And dear God, I am sick and tired of pulling this cart. I know. I should push it a while.
Tavia!
What is it, Tolga?
It's Hava. She left home this morning with Fiedka. I looked all over for her. I even went to the priest. He told me they were married.
Go home, Gold.
But Hava!
Forget about Hava. Go home. We will forget about her.
Papa, I want to talk with you. Hava, stop. At least listen to me. Papa, I beg you to accept us.
Accept them? How can I accept them? Can I deny everything I believe in? On the other hand, can I deny my own daughter? On the other hand, there is no other hand. No, Hava! No! No! outside world.
I've come here to tell you that I have order here. You're going to have to leave until
now. Please!
I'll stay the whole time out here.
Please!
And you, who have known us all your life, you would carry out this order.
I have nothing to do with it. Don't you understand?
We understand.
And what if he refuses to go?
You have 3 days.
We should defend ourselves. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth.
Oh, very good. And then the whole world will be blind and toothless. Almost finished inside.
Almost, Papa.
Papa!
be with you.
God be with you. We'll write you in America if you like. We'll be staying with Uncle Abram. Yes, Mama.
Bielka, sprint up. Put your bundles on the wagon. We have a train to catch.
Stop that! Behave yourselves!
Not in America yet.